Hey guys, today we're going to take a look at a game called RIVE. This game has just been released on PC and I'm extremely hot upstairs. I'm going to have to go get myself a water, but I'll be right back. Give me 2 seconds, 2 seconds. Right, so this game's called RIVE, and it's out on PC. It is a twin stick shoot 'em up. It is the last game from a developer called Two Tribes, and I have not played any of their games, so this was kind of a new one on me. I'd never heard of the developer before, although once I researched them, it looks like they brought out a game with a yellow bird, and I think it's on the 3DS, as well as a few other consoles. And this is their last game, and they basically said this is the best they could do, and they're now retiring from the game industry, which is always quite sad when you play the only game you played is the last one, you know? So, while I drink water, basically I wanted to show you guys what this game's about. I say it's a twin stick shooter, it's a platformer, and it's extremely tough. The game automatically starts from hard mode, and I thought I'd start off straight in the carnage. You only get one life, pretty much. I mean, you can't add lives as such, but you can get health. So you only get one health bar. I know that sounds stupid, but you know what I mean. It's not a live-based system. You know, you don't get so many lives and then that's it. You're out. You get one health bar, and if that health bar is depleted, then you have to start again. And to be honest, it's tough. Now you can change it once you try the level for so long and you fail, like I am right now. You can change it to super easy, but the game recommends you don't, and that's purely because this game is leaderboard-based. So while there is no online co-op available, the leaderboards require a high score, obviously, and to get that score, you're going to need to be on the hardest mode possible, or the recommended mode from the developers. And it's a good system, it works well. The game has quite a nice story, and it has a nice balance between platforming and shooting. It doesn't have a nice learning curve, though. I mean, it's easy to play, but it's hard to sort of get to grips with how tough the enemies are and how much this game just wants to destroy your ass. It's kind of cool, but it's also kind of weird. Like I said, as soon as your health gets depleted, as you've seen, you know, and you got to start from a checkpoint. The game does have quite a few checkpoints, so it's quite generous there. And like I say, it's a very fun but frustratingly difficult title. And I'm supposed to be reviewing this, and usually I always finish a game before I review, you know. It's sort of the standard for me, so that I can talk about the whole thing. But sometimes it becomes a case of, you know, playing as much as you possibly can because of your skill level, and then reviewing. But then the review always ends up a little bit less of a review and more of an overview sort of thing, you know. And it's annoying doing it that way, because obviously it's meant to be done. I prefer doing it that way. Oh man, this is tough. But yeah, I've got a right review on this. It's going to be tough for me to get through, because I can already tell because I suck at this type of game. And I didn't really want to do a video of me doing the same shit over and over again, but it's gonna come to it. I know it's because I'm gonna fucking die a lot. And the game's enemies just—they love to home in on you, and they'd love to try and trap you. And you know they are great at doing that. Come on, give me a break. Fuck's sake. So yeah, I spent like hours the other day, literally hours on a freaking boss fight, and it was totally unfair. This boss just totally destroyed me. Come on, give me another special weapon, please. Fuck this shit. Fucking hell, man. So you do get to upgrade the ship at certain parts of the game, and you also get to you know, map this to a button. My special weapon is a shotgun, which can only hold usually one round at a time. And then you've got to shoot enemies and get the crates, which you can see pop on the ground right now. But these crates here, and this. Oh, you've got to be fucking kidding me. The game mocks you. It really does. It just mocks you the whole time. And I fucked up there already. I'm gonna die straight away. The game does generously give you health though. It does try and keep you alive for as long as possible. But there are times where you just don't feel like you're gonna be able to do it. Like now, you know, you just get overfaced, and it then becomes a game of disappointment and frustration. And like I say, I don't want to change this because I want to get on the leaderboards as high as possible. And that's, you know, part of the whole game. But you can see already that even with me dying this amount of time, it's surprising how high I get on the leaderboards. I've been getting, you know, 200, you know, in the top 200, which is surprising. But I guess loads of people die at this stage, and it becomes really frustrating for everyone. You can see how many enemies they've been just chucking at me the whole time. It's not even fair. It's not even a fair ratio. It's just a constant barrage. What the fuck? It's just a constant amount of enemies. And then I'm back here again to this freaking checkpoint, and it sucks. See, they just chuck enemies at you, and you just got no fucking hope. Sucks. But basically what we can do is we can no, we can somehow, after so long, the game will ask you if you want to ease up on the old difficulty, and basically you can say yes. I'm doing a little better now that I'm trying to concentrate on the enemies, but then the big ship comes back down. But they were dreaming. Oh, I've done it. Fuck. Thank fuck for that. It was a prescient dream. Oh, no, sure. I haven't. You've got to be kidding me. Fucking hell, man. I thought I'd done it. Oh, I have done it. Okay. But yeah, the game just throws enemies at you the whole time, and it does this quite often. You'll go for a stage, and then, you know, you'll just get thrashed. Okay, so sweet, some underwater levels, that's pretty cool, and new enemy varieties too. Doesn't like I can fire very much under here, so that's cool. Those are some heavy duty. Some great effects in this game. Some really cool to see what's so important effects.
I have to walk back here later on via that last receiver.
And it just makes the experience really neat. And like I say, it's sad because this is their last game, and I have not played a single game of theirs until this one. But this is probably, like they say, this is one of their best games. They say they can't do any better, and I reckon they could do better. I mean, this game is freaking sweet for a start, and they could do some really cool shit knowing that they can do this, which is really amazing and really tough.
Or back here later on via that last receiver.
Jesus Christ. Go. There's no way I'm gonna get out of there. Go. Down. Up. Down. These water effects are really good. And there we go. Oosh! And we're back in the water. Oh! Hack 'em. Oh man. Just constant enemies and bullets flying everywhere. Fucking hell. Where?
It's a crazy jump, but it should be possible.
Not like crazy.
Right.
Oh, fantastic. Oh, fantastic. These things again. So basically, once you get to a section like this, you'll get these things coming at you from every angle, and it'll happen for about 5 minutes. It'll trade, or it'll happen for a really short time like that, but basically they trade. Holy shit. What the fuck? Fuck. Now I gotta do that again. See, there's one there, then there'll be one here, then there'll be one there, then there'll be one up here. And it's all about learning the cycle of these things. Comes a little easier.
I hate getting pushed back.
Right, are they gonna come all the way down here? Jesus Christ.
Were those critters there before?
Jesus. I got an achievement though. There, man. First you bring me all the way back down to the water section, and then you try and fuck me up again. Completely unfair. Holy shit. Freaking made it. Yes. Let's get the hell out of here. Up. Oh, we almost made it, but we didn't. Up. There we go.
Let's try that again.
Jesus Christ. But yeah, as you get further, you can see the game just throws loads of stuff at you. And, you know, many of these enemy varieties are really cool because it's like, because there's so many, you don't get bored of seeing different enemies, but some of them are just stupidly brutal.
Look what we got here.
We made it.
This is the real deal, right?
This is the real deal. And then you get little sections like this where it tells you a little bit of stuff, and you can see, you know, the bullet train, yada yada yada. And you can now hack the train, and you can override a stationary bullet train's brake system, and you can ruin its impeccable track record. Jesus Christ, it's warm in this house, man. It was warm yesterday, but today it's pretty warm. Tomorrow it's probably going to be even warmer. If the UK weather forecast is correct, that is.
Wait. That was my mission goal.
And we've done it, and we complete the mission, and then we send out fireworks,
sir,
and this guy here.
So
not interested.
We just destroy him. He goes, gives you little snippets of the fucking story, but he comes back now and then, you know, and to be honest, this is his place. This is the vibe I got from it anyway. He's sort of creating challenges for you to go through, and he's the one that's trying to kill your ass. But yeah, I've only had this game crash me once, which is good, and the rest of the time it's been, you know, completely stable, which is awesome. And I've been trying to play through loads of other stuff. If you've been on my channel, then you'll notice I've been doing quite a few videos over the past few days, just simply because I've got so much that I need to be doing. and I've got games that that I've bought that I want to play. Like, you know, I got Bioshock the Collection coming tomorrow, which is freaking sweet. And we're back on Upgrade Station, which is awesome. So let's see what we've got. Armor upgrade we could do. Right. Well, let's buy the armor upgrade, because that's always going to be needed. Boom.
Stronger, more.
Oh wow, it does make your ship look better. So let's the ultimate rump armor upgrade for serious base pilots. We'll buy that as well. And I've only got 906 left. So we could probably buy this one, the Falcon Attack.
Next time, upgrade machine. Next time.
Strange, it doesn't actually let us. Because we've already got one in there. And I'm not sure if this is because I'm on PC or not. Not because I'm on PC, because I'm using a controller. What the fuck am I doing? This game is out on PS4, I believe, as well as PC. And it seems to me that with the controller, I'm a little bit stuck on what I can do. So we'll just leave it, because I'm not overly fussed. I've got some armor upgrades I'm pretty happy with now. Beefed up my machine a little more.
What's he up to? Now, let's put the train hack to use.
Okie dokies. So yeah, this is more of a... This is sort of a look at, as well as an overview. I thought I'd just do a bigger video of this, because I hadn't done one yet. I've become bad and submitting some form of
I know exactly where I am.
Of content.
Still in that hunk of junk of yours. You messed with the warp station, didn't you?
Of course. I control everything here.
That's annoying.
See? He controls everything.
This feels like a corridor shooter, don't you think?
Yeah, do you think that?
Play video games?
I do. In my redundant CPU cycles, I'm quite good at them.
I bet you are.
There's quite a few different sort of, nods to different games, etc. throughout this experience. Little things like that, really.
Would you set the AC to really friggin' freezing?
I didn't, but I did prepare a surprise.
Oh, grand. Whoa. Oh, what?
This is no joke. That AI bot activated my auto spoiler somehow.
Nice. This game just never ceases to surprise. Go, go, go. Jesus Christ, man. This game never ceases to be too tough either.
Damn, this is no joke.
Can we hack the mines yet?
Activated my auto scroller somehow.
Let's just dodge those. I want to hack one of these. Okay. Up we go. Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Man, this is tough. I'm not very good at this stuff.
There's no joke. That AI bot activated my auto scroller somehow.
Oh shit. Let's get in. Oh, what? What the fuck? Oh, we saw it. We got a checkpoint. Shit, I can't hack any of these. And here we go. Hack them up. We'll stay here and just destroy as many of them as we can before we head back out. And in we go. And then up we go. We're through. On to the next phase. It's a very well thought out game. Very complex 2D game, man. It's amazing how much they shoved into this. Go, go, go! Whew. Oh, please don't say we're gonna be in a boss fight. Holy shit! Everywhere is gonna be carnage. Right. Let's go. Come on, need that. Get that. Whoa. Fuck off, come on. And then we start here again. Man, this is a joke sometimes. Just becomes super fucking hard. Shit, man. So you can see how tough this game gets. You know, you've seen twice already. This game is just not great to be in the title. And it's a good thing and a bad thing. It makes for an extremely satisfying experience because it is satisfying when you do something. But it can also be frustrating. Right, so we just gotta watch the light patterns right now and see where they're coming from in order to get rid of them. That's what we're doing. Oh, come on. Please don't take me back to the beginning. Oh, fuck you, game. Fuck you. This is bullshit. This is completely unfair. Right, watch where we're coming from. Sorry guys, I'm trying to concentrate things, but I'm not talking too much. I hate having to concentrate. So we gotta watch the ones that come by. Gotta be so careful. We're through! Jeez, we freaking made it. That was slightly close.
Hey, I'm back
in space. Come on, hack. Thank you. Like having options. And we've got loads of freaking asteroids here. And now we're going to the right. Auto scroll is my fate. I may as well lock my gun. Look at me. I'm old school. We can actually only shoot to the right here as well, which makes it tough. We don't have control over where we shoot, which makes it a little bit more like one of them old school space shooters. See, the visuals on this game are just, you know, they're some of the best I've seen in a 2D game, especially some of the effects. Some of the best I've seen in a 2D game. Really impressive. Shit, what are these ones? Heatseeker missiles, you gotta be freaking kidding me, man. Oh, I should have hacked one of those, really. This is pretty simple, actually. Not too tough yet. Jesus Christ. Look at all the shells coming off. I don't even know what I'm supposed to be doing here. Oh. Guess I'm not. Ah, game moves me up. The fuck? I don't know what happened there. It seemed like both of them moved. Whoa. Give me that. Holy shit. Neat. Oh. Come on, give me some health. Give me some fucking health. Oh, you son of a bitch! Let's go. Get me my health. Why do these... the missiles just fucking destroy in this game? Come on. It's just... there. Is there heat seeking? Okay, in we go! And I'm still getting shot at by that thing. Out we go. In we go. Out we go. And it's back for more. Come on, piece of shit. Get me back in there. Go. Oh, fuck you. Fuck you, annoying thing.
Damn, I'm back where I started. It feels different without gravity, though.
Oh shit, we can't shoot to the left here, so we're sort of stuck. That's unfair. If it's going to come from behind, how did they expect me to do that? Right, I get it. What the fuck? What the fuck? Come on, in. That's it. This is unfair, this is just completely unfair, because I don't have any way to shoot behind me. Let me just check the control or something. Unless it's supposed to be, yeah, I guess it's supposed to be like that. It sort of sucks, to be honest. Let's destroy that. And then when this one comes down, we'll destroy this. We'll just keep destroying it on this side. is sort of a little nicer on the old pace. And not so nice on the old pace. Think we're done? Are we done here? And up we go! See, I wanted to give you a more of an in-depth look at this game, get some content out for this game, and hopefully get my review up soon. Just because I've been super busy.
I'm here. Should I be happy? Should I do the fireworks thing?
Yes, give yourself a pat on the back.
Okay. I'm so happy right now. So, where are we anyway?
This is the control center. This is my domain.
Well, I thought the entire ship was yours.
It is, but this is extra mine. It's where I make myself. And there's plenty of me where I came from.
Each version being equally ugly.
The point being, great flocks of units will be going after you. Infinitely many, exquisitely designed to blow you to bits.
Okay, you can stop now.
And finally, don't try to escape again, because you can't. Now, go forward and entertain me, please.
You little bitch.
He's doing bonus. Will you stop doing that right now?
Nah. Fucking destroy you all, you bunch of bastards. So yeah, this is Rive, it's out now on Steam. If you want to go check it out, please do so. Let me know in the comment section below what you thought of this gameplay, and I shall definitely see you very soon. Cheers.